All right, it is South Jersey weather time. I'm meteorologist Joe Martucci, and we're at Frog Pond Elementary School in Little Lake Harbor. All right, and join with me. We have two maybe future meteorologists. Guys, can you tell us who you are and what grade you're in?
I'm Christopher Sona.
Okay.
And I'm Ava Vanarelli.
Okay, and what grade are you guys in?
We're in fourth grade.
So you guys are in fourth grade. All right, and we were talking about weather a little bit today. Tell us what we have going outside today.
Today's a little rainy.
Okay. What else do we have going on today?
It's a bit cloudy.
So it's been cloudy today. It's been rainy today. It's not the best day. Not a good recess day either, right, guys?
Mm-hmm.
No, not a good recess day. But we're going to have some better weather, at least some drier weather over the next couple of days. The rain that we've had throughout the day today will be coming to an end by between 6 to 8 p.m. And then what we're going to see after that is winds flip to the northwest. We're going to get colder out. We're going to start drying out. We actually should be partly cloudy for most of the night. Temperatures are going to fall through the 40s and then get into the 30s by the time we get towards Tuesday morning. So we have temperatures tomorrow morning, the upper 30s, near 40 degrees. What do you guys think you guys are going to wear when you guys are coming into school tomorrow?
Winter jacket.
Winter jacket. All right, so we're thinking winter jacket. That's a good idea here, too. Now, we're going to be dry for a couple of days, but we have the wet weather today. And as it turns out, this is, year-to-date, the wettest year we have had in South Jersey history, in recorded history. Atlantic City International Airport has been wet so much here. We're almost double the average where we should be for this time of year. And we're about 5 inches away, only 5 inches away from the all-time record wettest year. We have about a half inch to an inch today. Looks like we're going to have some more rain as we get towards next weekend. So here we go. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, all looking to be about the same, guys. We have temperatures in the 40s. It's going to be windy all 3 days. We have a northwest wind around 15 to 20 miles an hour. Gusts are going to be in the 30s. Should be in the 40s as we go into Wednesday. High temperatures on Tuesday. Going to be in the mid to upper 40s. Wednesday, probably only around 40 degrees, and it's going to be windy. Do you guys like that? 40 degrees, windy?
No.
Okay, we don't like that. It's a little cold. Wind chill. He said wind chill. Good point. Wind chills on Wednesday are going to be in the 20s. We go to Thursday, still a little breezy. Again, temperatures are going to rise through the 40s, so we should see a good amount of sunshine on our Thursday. And then as we look at Friday, the end of the week, we like Friday, right?
Yeah.
Friday's a good day. Friday looking pretty good. There's one exception. Should have a partly sunny sky, but we have a weak system that comes through during the afternoon. And what that's going to do is that's going to bring isolated showers, rain showers, for the end of Friday. Let's take a quick look at the weekend here. Saturday looking dry. Sunday, we have another coastal storm coming our way. Details are a little murky just now, but wind, rain, coastal flooding, all in the realm of possibility. So from here at Frog Pond School in Little Lake Harbor, I'm meteorologist Joe Martucci. You guys want to say goodbye?
Bye.
All right. Thank you, guys. Have a great rest of the night.